These acorn nuts can get a little deformed, especially if they had a copper washer under it. And we're going to be using a rubber, a steel washer encased in rubber. And you can get a leak. I don't know if you can see this. It could be quite difficult to see. But that's not flat. Right? That has a little bit of a section right there where it's been on the washer. And it's got a hump in it. That'll cause a leak. So we want to get this flat and ensure that we are not going to leak. Because once we put this thing together, if we have a leak, we're not going to know about it until it's too late. So I just got some crocus cloth. Flat part of the bench. Some high-tech machine shop work here. And that one's flat. Very difficult to see on the camera, but it's nice and flat. That one's really got a ridge in it. I don't know what it's going to look like on the camera, but it's a pretty good ridge. Thank you.
When you're working back in this shop in the summertime, that's what you don't want to see when you look out. Not a breeze to be found.
Looks like a very hot day.
And then if you look over here, the building on this side of the shop. So we got a building on this side of the shop, a hedgerow on that side of the shop. There's absolutely no airflow that comes through this building. That section of building on the other side of the blue door gets plenty of airflow because they get the wind across the parking lot. But my three doors are blocked, so I get no airflow through here. I get man-made airflow. The airflow I brought from the house. So let's talk about these turbos real quick before we put them down. This is the EGR catalyst. Pretty neat little unit. Keeps the crud out of the EGR coolers. Let's see here. I've only put one half of the shield on, because once we put the turbos on and the fuel cooler, then we're going to prime this fuel system and check it for leaks. We're going to make sure we don't have any leaks right there. And over there. So if you were to take this intake manifold off here and not mark where the studs went, you would be tempted. Put a stud right there in that location, and that would be an extremely costly mistake, because if you were to put that over a stud and then put a nut on top of it, that can't move. It'd be bolted down so rigid that the turbo and that pipe heat up at a different rates, and this can actually leak oil past this O-ring right here. So it only needs to be bolted down right there, and that allows it to flex. That thing can move around to allow for expansion, contraction with heat. All right. Now, if you'll notice, one dowel pin stayed in the pedestal, one came out, stayed in the turbo. I don't care for mismatched setup like that, so I'm actually going to pull this one out of the turbo and pull that one out of the pedestal. Clean them up and then goop them up with some anti-seize, some never-seize. We'll reinstall it. Well, this turbo's been off of this vehicle before. One way to tell, first of all, this gasket's all beat up. That drain tube's upside down. So the drain tube should be taper side down. So it should fit in the turbo on this end, and this end will go into the turbo pedestal. So we're ready to set this on.